I hit the pavement, running amok and I don't stop. I've been living the same day for the past 6 months in a daze, because I'm doing what I love. And I won't leave the stage until you motherfuckers jump. I leave my pride inside oblivion. Don't take yourself so serious, life is just a game.
Work today, de-leafing some bananas, but as you can see, shiz a smick day. I just thought I'd show you the view. Kiss the breeze, let your rhythm flow. Alright, so what you want to do is, there's no need to get rid of the spider, but you take off that one, and we'll just rest that there, and you get rid of the little spider, there you go. So that's the bell. You want to, boom, snap that off. And then you've got the hands here. So go one, two, and then we'll leave about three. So yeah, take off the bell, couple hands, and then leave a couple. And then chuck a bag on it. All right, so yeah, the reason why we take off the bell and a couple hands, because of the age old thing, quantity versus quality, you know? So instead of having a whole bunch of half okay fruit, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hands of premium fruit. That's what you want. So once you've hit it with the cane knife, you pull the bunch down onto your shoulder. Then with your other hand, you cut it off the tree. And then while it's on the shoulder, you cut the tree off. So you only get one bunch of fruit per one tree. The mother tree will throw a baby tree. The baby tree will throw another tree. And basically we just keep walking. It's good to be finished that. You know when your neck gets that sore and you like look and it's like, boom, if I look any faster than this, I'm gonna break my neck. But I've been looking up at these trees for like this whole 3-4 months, whatever this, however far we are along in this year. Bro, my neck is that sore. I'm going home. So yeah, I've been using this full bore air compressor for over a year now. Haven't had any problems with it. So shout out to Full Bore. If you want to send me any more products, you know, you can. Good little product review. Does all the jobs you need to. The ute, the mower, the tractor. Gets it all sorted. quick and easy pack away. And yeah, no complaints at all.
I keep running down the same road, and the people keep on coming down to my show. Hold the king's memory and all the burnt bridges. Could a body would put it back together again? I keep falling down the same stairs to a city with an integrity plan to brainwash all my ears. I'm free falling through the slideshow, free falling true and slow. Free falling won't stop me no more, 'cause I'm a bootleg rascal.
Yeah, just finished most of the mowing. Shout out to John Deere. I put this thing through its paces hard. Like, she's maintaining about 15 acres here. No tractor, no slasher, just the John Deere. And I bought it second hand. So I really recommend John Deere's. She's the way to go. She smashes it out. 'Cause yeah, you can see what I'm dealing with. I would have took it in there, but it's dirt jumps in there, and I don't think the mower's going to handle dirt jumps too well. Was gonna make this episode all about dirt jumps and my BMX. Ended up just going crazy on the mower. Made a driveway and everything. But yeah, just forgot that I got a ute load full of spider lilies. These things here. And they've been sitting here for about 3-4 days. And you can see I got a lot of them to plant. And I was just packing up, ready to go home. And now I've got to dig about 2, maybe 3,000 holes. Yeah. Passion fruit bagola with this, with some twine. So you have to cut down passion fruit every couple years, and this stuff lasts a couple years, so I'm thinking, why not try it? You ready? Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, she's a bit hot today, out in the sun, so gonna take the dogs in for a swim, and yeah, leave them at home while I head out and do some work. Lucky dogs. So yeah, we're underneath the rainforest canopy. We've got this little spring here. It's only about knee deep, ankle deep. It's got some little drop-offs and holes, but otherwise it's super cold. It's autumn here in far north Queensland, but it doesn't feel like it. It's about 36 degrees humidity. And yeah, this water here is, one day I'll get a thermometer and we'll show you, but yeah, super cold. It's like doing a little ice bath. Super grateful for it. Yeah, no one else comes here besides me. Although downstream about 3 km is a known spot for saltwater crocodiles, but here it's too cold for them. There's lots of little jungle perch and black brim and little fish and food supply for crocodiles. We got fresh waters in here, but thankfully, touch wood, no saltwater crocodiles. That's why always stay in about knee depth. If you can't see the bottom, don't go in anywhere up here in far north Queensland or croc country in general. Stay safe.
You just gotta get in.
Little morning swim. I got a splinter in my foot, so I got to walk back to the house and get that out. But yeah, I'll go do some work and we'll be back swimming this afternoon. So end the swim short.
Alright, so that's right there, and that's the guinea grass behind me. So that's about 9 foot, 10 foot tall grass that just spreads. So that's my biggest battle. It's a war.
I think I should do this. Are you still listening? You know, what's it gonna be like when I ain't doing this music thing anymore? I'm not gonna be going on tours or shows every other weekend. Like, what are people gonna start saying? Oh, class? Yeah, he's falling off. Yeah. I know the way the world works. Don't put this on in a couple years. Listen. I know that everything that goes up must come down, yeah. And everybody with luck must run out, yeah. So now we're contemplating like, what's up now? The music thing is all gone, but I'll suck it up proud. I did more than I imagined, tours I couldn't fathom. Broke down doors, for sure I let them have it. If any opportunity came, I had to grab it. Any goal set, I rose and ran past it. Not a superstar and never wanted that, but I did sign some autographs on some groupies.